Yeah. tenor sax, lead vocals, and fantastic dancing. Terry Bozio on drums. Tom Fowler on bass. Denny Wally on slide. George Duke on keyboards. And Captain Beef Hart on soprano sax. And forgetfulness. At the risk of making you think that our program is too slow-paced, we're going to continue in this drudgerous sort of a vein for a few moments with another song that we open our program with. This is a song about feet and the problems attendant thereto. The name of the song is Stinkfoot. Shark bubbles flow in the morning by your radio. Do the walls close in to suffocate you? You ain't got no friends, and all the others are hate you. Does the life you've been leading gotta go? Well, let me straighten you out about a place I know. Get your shoes and socks on, people. It's right around the corner over by the rectory. You go out through the night and a whispering breeze through the place where they keep the imaginary diseases. Out through the night and a whispering breeze through the place where they keep the imaginary diseases. Call this disease bromidrosis, and well they should. But us regular Catholics who might wear an occasional tennis shoe or maybe a little python know this exquisite little ecumenical inconvenience by the name of Stinkfoot. Mother Mary and Joseph, how true that is. Oh my, python boot was too tight. I couldn't get it off last night. A week went by, my scapular got dry. I tried to get it off and my girlfriend cried. We got Stinkfoot. Stinkfoot, darling. Your Stinkfoot puts the hurts on my plenary indulgence. Stinkfoot, Stinkfoot, Iron Lion. Will you do a novena for me tonight during the program? Here we go. Fido, please, please, Fido, bring the slippers right over here. Put them right over by my Wawa pedal. We'll be right back. the song is I'm Not Satisfied, and it goes like this. Charleston, spider. Then she gave a pair of shoes to me. I said, well, the 14 shuffle tea. Then she gave a pair of shoes to me. Magic is a real, no, no. This turmoil, which is so indicative of our modern society, has beset each and every one of us at one time or another. I know that some people don't like to discuss loneliness in public, you know. They like to whimper about it in the privacy of their own homes. They like to say that everybody's not lonely, it's just me that's lonely, it's only me that is hurting to my heart. But ladies and gentlemen, if there's one thing I have found in my travels throughout the rock and roll industry, including across the ocean, everybody in the world is lonely. They're all hurting. And the reason for this is because everybody wants true love. Now, what is true love?
Get down.
Ladies and gentlemen, there have been a number of songs written about the subject true love, and they all seem to have one factor in common. Amen. None of them make any sense at all.
Amen.
Because when you want to talk about love, and love is, let's face it, as you say in your language, something deep and personal that you feel deep down in your soul, by way of your heart. Now they say that sometimes it hurts to be in love, and sometimes love can make your mind go wild. Love can make you feel like a king, and if you're a little bit weird, it can make you feel like a queen. But love will inevitably, even when it's working good, love will generate loneliness. Because even if you have love, and your loved one is with you, when you go away from your loved one, you will be lonely for your loved one, won't you?
I need you.
And then, of course, the person that you love will be lonely for you.
Talk about it. Talk about it.
So let's face it, folks, there's no way out. Even if you get true love, you are going to be lonely. You might as well stick your head between your legs and kiss your ass goodbye. Loneliness, you're going to have to live with it. Or throughout the velvet sunrise of your later teenage years. Somebody say amen to it.
Oh, windy hole 100 yards away.
song now about dental floss. And the song is Montana.
Thank you. Everything is silly, folks.
I'm gonna find me a horse just about this big and ride that sucker all along the borderline with a pair of heavy duty zircon encrusted tweezers in my hand. Every other wrangler would say I was mighty great. By myself, I would have no boss, 'cause I'd be raising my lonely gentle boss. Then I give a cup of coffee and give my foot a push. Just me and the pygmy pony over by the dental floss bush. And then I might just jump that horse and ride like a cowboy into the dawn of the Montana. Into Montana soon. Pretending to play a finger cymbal. Yes, that's it. George usually starts off this part of our show by taking this finger cymbal. It looks about like this. It's a small piece of metal that he agitates with a stick. And sometimes during this agitation of the small metal object with the stick, he pretends to hit his thumb and hurt himself. Do it again, George. They love violence. Then, after he has worked you into a veritable frenzy by pretending to hurt his hand with the stick, George will improvise a spectacular keyboard extravaganza for you and yours. Take it away, George.
If you know better, don't you worry.
don't you worry, ain't gonna hurt you now. Take it on, baby.
What's wrong with that? You know what I'm talking about.
Oh, no.
What does this object mean to you? Does this signify... Wait a minute, let me get it by its delicate little handle. Does this signify rah-rah, bula-bula? Or does it signify dumbness? Or is there a difference between rah-rah, bula-bula, and dumbness? Let's vote on it. How many say rah-rah and bula-bula was really cool? You have a lot of school spirit, don't you? How many say rah-rah and bula-bula is caca? A highly evolved college audience, if ever I heard one. We return you now to the adventures of Captain Report Card. box, report card. Okay, now ladies and gentlemen, you have to let your mind drift back. Some of you will have to let your mind drift back to before you were even born. You're going back past rock and roll, way back before the Beatles, back almost before there was Joe Houston, back when there was Beatniks. Welcome to the Mothers of Invention Poetry and Jazz Hour, starring Captain Report Card.
Sam with a showing scalp flat top. Why, when I was knee-high to a grasshopper, this black juice came out on a hard-shelled chin. And they called that tobacco juice. I used to fiddle with my back feet music for a black onyx. My entire room absorbed every echo. The music was...
Thud.
I usually played such things as Roughneck and Thug. Opaque melodies that would bug most people.
Thudneck.
Music from the other side of the fence. A black swan figurine lay on all color lily pads on a little conglomeration table of pressed black felt with same colored shadows. And seamed knob knees and whatnots. Long hallway rolled out into oddball odd beside the fly pecked black doorway. That looked closed on the tar lattice straight. Up a wrought iron fire escape rolled out a tiny wooden platform with hard dark rubber wheels. Sam with a showing scalp flat top, particular about the point it made. Sam was a basket case, a hard, dark ivory cup held saleable everyday pencils. The music was thud-like. The music was thud-like. Thud-like.
The name of the song is Penguin in Bondage. Penguin in Bondage, boy.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah!
Way over on the west side of the bed. Penguin, flap the feet out to me. Lord, you know it's all over. If she come at you on the strut and wrap them all around your head, flap the feet out to me.
Thank you. Thank you.
thank you, Lady Moon. In the frostbite night, with the flaps gone white, shrieking as she's by the room across the room. You know it must be a penguin bound down. Can you hear that terrible screaming? And there ain't no other birds around. Just like a penguin in bondage, boy.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
She's just like a penguin in bondage.
Just might box your dog. Cause she just might box your doggy.
And maybe a dried up dog biscuit. Cowboy song for you. This is a special sort of a cowboy song because it deals with the subject of our impending bicentennial celebration. As you know, next year our country is going to be 200 years old. Such a deal. I'm sure you're aware of that. But do you realize that for years, grubby little merchants across the land have been planning to rip you off by making available next year a wide assortment of cheesy little trinkets and doodads for you to buy. And this is a song about somebody in a place called Pufter's Froth, Wyoming, who planned many years ago to set you up for the big cheese next year. And here it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you. Thank you.
Potato Head Bobby was a friend of mine. Opened three of his eyes in the food stamp line. Opened four of his eyes in the food stamp line. Opened five of his eyes in the food stamp line. Opened six of his eyes in the food stamp line. What's this? What's your thing?
Like a rock and roll concert. Thank you.